I extend a warm welcome to all of you to this evening's function. The third Visitors Awards will be conferred upon the winners by the Honorable President of India today. At the outset, I want to inform that the Visitors Awards in the three categories of Best University, Innovation and Research were instituted for the Central Universities in 2014. The Honorable President, during the Conference of VCs of Central Universities in Feb 2014, had announced the institution of these awards. The objective of these awards is to encourage healthy competition among central universities and to spur excellence in them. The Visitors Awards comprises for the best university a citation and trophy, and to the awardees of both innovation and research, a citation and cash reward of rupees 1 lakh each. The first Visitors Awards were presented in 2015 during the VCs conference. The second awards were presented in 2016 during the Festival of Innovation. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable President, in his addresses and interfaces with the central institutions of higher learning, has always stressed on adherence to highest standards of education and a relentless move towards excellence. He has been outlining the areas that require improvement, such as faculty development, use of IT, creation of world-class facilities, and institution to institution and institution industry linkages. And above all, he has been emphasizing on creating a friendly and stimulating environment for research and innovation. The Visitors Awards echo these focal areas of the Honorable President. With these few words, I once again welcome you all. I now request Secretary to the President, Srimati Amita Paul, who is also the chairperson of the selection committee for the Visitors Awards, to kindly give her observations on this occasion.
A very good evening to all of you. It is my pleasure to welcome you all to this presentation ceremony of the Visitors Awards 2017. These are third in the series of awards which were first presented in 2015. I had the privilege to chair the committee that recommended the award winners to the Honorable President. It is therefore my solemn duty to express before this August gathering my profound gratitude to the members of the selection committee for their work and effort in finalizing the awardees, following a rigorous and elaborate procedure. May I also take this opportunity to place on record my appreciation on behalf of the committee for three experts, Professor Furkan Kamar, Secretary General Association of Indian Universities, Professor Anil K. Gupta, Executive Vice Chairman, National Innovation Foundation, and Professor Anil Wali, Managing Director, Foundation for Innovation and Technology Transfer, IIT Delhi, for assisting this committee by meticulously undertaking a preliminary scrutiny of the applications. The list of awardees this year, as like the earlier 2 years, reflect President Mukherjee's thrust areas for the higher education sector, as also his vision for a strong research and innovation ecosystem. Ladies and gentlemen, the Visitors Awards 2017 will be conferred upon the following: the Best University, Jawaharlal Nehru University, for academic excellence and overall outstanding performance. For innovation, Dr. Deepak Pant, Associate Professor and Dean, Department of Environmental Sciences, Central University of Himachal Pradesh, for developing a reactor for direct conversion of waste plastic to LPG on small scale. And for research, Dr. Shyam Sunder, Professor, Department of Medicine, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University, for his pioneering work in the area of diagnosis and treatment of Indian Kala-azar. And Dr. Niranjan Karak, Professor, Department of Chemical Sciences, Tezpur University, for the development of renewable resource-based, bio-degradable, hyper-branched polymer nano-composites as self-cleaning, self-healing, and biocompatible, sustainable, futuristic material. My heartiest congratulations to all the winners of the awards. These awards, I'm sure, will stimulate the drive to uplift educational standards in our central universities and provide a direction for research and innovation activities. With these few words, let me once again welcome you all to this evening's program. Thank you.
Visitors Award 2017 for research will now be conferred upon the joint winners by the Honorable President. I request both the winners to kindly come up on stage and receive the honors, Professor Shyam Sunder and Ann Karak. The Visitors Award 2017 for Innovation will now be awarded by the Honorable President. I request the winner to kindly come up on stage and receive the citation and cash award, Professor Deepak Pant. I request the Vice Chancellor of Jawaharlal Nehru University, Prof. M. Jagdish Kumar, to kindly come up on stage and receive the citation and trophy. I request the Honorable Minister of HRD to kindly release this book and present its first copy to the Honorable President. I also request for this Secretary General Association of Indian Universities to kindly come up on stage and facilitate in releasing the book.
यहाँ उपस्थित सभी विद्वान और मान्यवर जो विभिन्न दायित्वों को संभाल रहे हैं और शिक्षा क्षेत्र को नेतृत्व दे रहे हैं, ऐसे सभी नेताओं का मैं स्वागत करता हूँ। हमारे राष्ट्रपति जी ऐसे हैं कि जिन्होंने बहुत नए इनिशिएटिव्स लिए। He is such an innovative president that he took many initiatives which were not taken earlier. First, he started with visitors conference, where all the central, all the vice chancellors and leaders of institutes of which he is the visitor, and nearly 100 plus universities and other institutes. So he brings all them together. And for 3 days, there is always a very good discussion. And stemming from that, this is yet another initiative of awarding, recognizing, and conferring on them visitors award, which actually propels quality competitiveness amongst the universities. And this is particularly for central universities. And this is really, it helps innovation and it helps research. It focuses on innovation and research and it focuses on competitiveness and excellence. I think for that, we all should clap for our president because उन्होंने एक कैसे रास्ते पर चलना चाहिए और क्या उसके लिए करना चाहिए इसका एक आदर्श स्थापित किया इसके लिए हम उनका बहुत अच्छा है। अब हम जब ये देख रहे थे तो काला आजार पर मुझे भी अच्छा लगा कि कितने अच्छे अच्छे केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालयों में संशोधन हो रहा है और काला आजार पर कैसे नई चिकित्सा प्रणाली तैयार करने का काम हो रहा है BHU में, प्लास्टिक से LPG, ये तो मैं पर्यावरण का मंत्री रहा, रोज 6000 टन प्लास्टिक कलेक्ट होता है, लेकिन 15000 टन यूज होता है, यानी 9000 टन वैसे ही पूरे पर्यावरण में वैसे ही बिखर रहा जाता है, और वही सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है। तो प्लास्टिक का विघटन करके बहुत सारे उपयोग के लिए अभी विज्ञान है, लेकिन वो भी पोल्यूशन फ्री प्लास्टिक डायरेक्टली टू LPG, कन्वर्टिंग दैट इनटू LPG इज अ बिग थिंग। आई सिंसियरली वेरी मच नॉट ओनली थैंक बट आई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट द प्रोफेसर हु हैज डन दिस एमिनेंट रिसर्च। पॉलीमर फ्रॉम बायो वेस्ट, द वे ही हैज कन्वर्टेड, आई कुडंट अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग बिकॉज आई एम नॉट फ्रॉम टेक्नोलॉजी और साइंस फील्ड, बट वॉट दे आर डूइंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट विल टेक इंडिया फॉरवर्ड। इनोवेशन एंड रिसर्च इज द बेडरॉक ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन एंड हैज टू बी, एंड दैट ओनली एड्स वैल्यू टू द प्रोडक्ट्स सर्विसेस एंड इट क्रिएट्स न्यू अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर जॉब्स एंड एवरीथिंग एंड इट टेक्स इकोनॉमी टू ए नेक्स्ट लेवल। प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी जो मेक इन इंडिया कहते हैं, वो मेक इन इंडिया का मुख्य सिद्धांत ही यहाँ इनोवेशन हो ये है, और इनोवेशन और रिसर्च के आधार पर ही उच्च शिक्षा का भविष्य तय होता है, और इसलिए इन सबको मैं बधाई देता हूँ। JNU को सबसे बेस्ट यूनिवर्सिटी का अवार्ड मिला है, मुझे लगता है दूसरे रैंकिंग में भी उनको मिला, तो ये जो अवार्ड मिला है इसके लिए JNU के वाइस चांसलर आए, उनके और हजारों छात्र, प्रतिभावान छात्र देश भर से आते केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय में, हजारों प्राध्यापक है जो बहुत डेडिकेशन से शिक्षा के लगन से जिस तरह से दिखाया कि बायोटेक्नोलॉजी में कैसे कैसे काम JNU में चल रहा है, ये JNU का परिचय है। जो हेडलाइंस में होता है वो नहीं है, जो न्यूज़पेपर में हम पढ़ते हैं वो नहीं है, ये JNU है, और ये बहुत मुझे अच्छा लगता है इसका, क्योंकि पुरस्कार देश तोड़ने के नारे लगाने के लिए नहीं दिया है, पुरस्कार वाइस चांसलर को रात भर बंधक बनाए रखने के लिए नहीं दिया है, क्योंकि दैट इज अनडेमोक्रेटिक प्रोटेस्ट, DP त्रिपाठी जी ने कहा कि दिस इज अनडेमोक्रेटिक प्रोटेस्ट, उसके लिए नहीं दिया, विचारों की आज़ादी। और उसके साथ साथ ये जो काम वहाँ हजारों हजारों छात्र जिस लगन से अध्ययन कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि एक यूनिवर्सिटी के छात्र पर 2.5 लाख रुपया खर्चा होता है साल का, वो कौन करता है, क्योंकि यूनिवर्सिटी में तो 6000 रुपये फी है, तो ये जो देते हैं वो समाज का गरीब आदमी देता है। और मैं इसलिए सभी सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज़ के छात्रों को कहता हूँ कि उनकी याद रखो, उनका स्मरण करो और उनके लिए काम की प्रतिज्ञा करो, और इसलिए आज JNU को भी बहुत बहुत बधाई, और अच्छा किया, इससे कॉम्पिटिशन है, अब इतने सारे केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय है वो अच्छे चले और इसी रास्ते पर चले तो इनोवेशन और रिसर्च से ही देश आगे बढ़ेगा, और जो देश आगे बढ़ेगा तभी हमारा सपना साकार होगा, और इसलिए सभी विजेताओं को और सभी पुरस्कार मिला उनका भी बधाई, और आने वाले सालों में इससे भी अच्छा काम करके अच्छा पुरस्कार प्राप्त करने के लिए बाकी सबको भी बधाई, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
गुड इवनिंग, श्री प्रकाश जावड़ेकर, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट, मिसेस अमिता पॉल्स, सेक्रेटरी टू द प्रेसिडेंट, Sri Keval Kumar Sharma, Secretary, Higher Education, Minister of Human Resource Development, Dr. Thomas Mathu, Additional Secretary to President, winners of the Visitors Award 2017, members of the Selection Committee of the Visitors Award, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It began with, let me congratulate the winners of Visitors Award 2017. Jawaharlal Nehru University, which has been adjudged as the best university, and the scientists from the Central University of Himachal Pradesh, Banaras Hindu University, and Tezpur University, who have been awarded in the categories of innovation and research. The honors conferred today lent due credence to their single-minded devotion and painstaking work in the pursuit of excellence. This recognition should, on the one hand, inspire them to higher levels of performance, and on the other hand, spur researchers and scientists in the Central University system to explore wider domains of human understanding. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, a lot has been said about the quality of India's higher education system. Many have debated that standards are declining as a corollary of the vast expansion seen over the past few years. Yet, many have argued that increasing our capacity to provide higher education is a dire need in the context of growing young population. There are over 250 million young men and women, one-fifth of the country's population, in the age group of 15 to 24. The onus is on the higher education system to realize their aspirations and perfect their scholastic potential. I, for one, do not see any dichotomy between greater access and better quality, or between higher quality and superior standards. It is entirely possible for the attributes of quantity and quality to move in the same direction at the same time. Distinguished guests, the concept of world-class institutions have engaged the minds of policymakers, educators, and academic experts. The jury is still out on what elements a world-class institution constitutes, and whether some features of such institutions can be specific to the context of a region or an economy. But presence of certain key traits is essential to level the institution world class. Let me outline a few of them. A sizable presence of the meritorious students and faculty. This does not happen all on a sudden, as institutions have to attain a certain degree of maturity before it starts gathering a pool of talented people. Many of our institutions of recent vintage may face problems in the beginning on this account, but policy catalysts may help. Under the global initiative of academic networks, Gyan programs, about 780 foreign faculty experts have enrolled to teach in Indian institutions. We are also witnessing a favorable economic climate, putting Indians working abroad back to their motherland to seek the opportunities emerging here. Our institutions would do well to leverage this brain drain. Secondly, adequacy of financial resources to boost physical infrastructure and academic resources. Institutions have to look beyond government funding to innovative mechanisms like industrial projects, sponsorship of chairs, and tie-ups for setting up research facilities. A governance model that allows institutions to respond quickly to change with enforcing a mechanism of critical analysis and honest reflection. Such a system requires strong institutional leaders who can enlist the cooperation and commitment of all in defining the vision of the institution. It also calls for a building cadre of academic leaders who can inspire followership among students and fellow educators. Drafting alumni and industry experts in governance structure too can bring in a fresh perspective to the academic environment. An ecosystem that supports research and innovation. A challenge for our institutions has been to retain bright students after education to do research. Good students either have leave formal education to enter the corporate, government, and other sectors, or pursue a higher degree in universities abroad. To arrest this trend, we need to make holistic changes in our education system. The pedagogy in our institutions at all levels has to promote creative thinking and novel learning and scientific scrutiny. An atmosphere where learning modules are supplemented by inquiry-based project work will be necessary. This will build in students an inclination to do research and to innovate. If we have a large pool of meritorious researchers complemented by top-level research laboratories, tie-ups with the industry, collaborations with foreign institutions, and an attractive compensation system, our institutions could be involved in doing more cutting-edge research and technology. Friends, areas for research activity should align with the developmental challenges of our nation. The best minds in our various universities should apply themselves to work out solutions in areas like sanitation, urban transportation, sewage disposal, clean river system, healthcare, and drought-resistant farming. They should also convert new knowledge into innovative products that are directly beneficial to the common population. Innovative minds should create tools and implements that alleviate the drudgery of farmers, workers, artisans, and weavers. The number one barometer for successful outcome of research and innovation should be its beneficial applicability to a wider section of the society. I am happy that the awardees in both innovation and research adequately meet this benchmark. The award-winning innovation of Dr. Deepak Pant a reactor for direct conversion of waste plastic to LPG has great potential for meeting the energy requirements at grassroots as well as protection of the environment. Dr. Shyam Sunder's groundbreaking research in the diagnosis and treatment of Indian Kala-azar has relevance in improving the health profits of its population. The pioneering work of Professor Niranjan Karak in the field of chemical science has scope for wide application, especially in the context of resource conservation. It is gratifying to note such good quality research and innovation taking place in our central universities. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, JNU has been adjudged as the best university for the unrelenting pursuit of academic excellence. It has shown outstanding performance in all key parameters, like quality of students and faculty, training of faculty, citations, publications, research projects, foreign collaborations, seminars and innovation exhibitions. I urge upon the university to continue the good work they are doing. Many central universities that have been set up in the recent years may not be in the reckoning for top honors immediately, but they must start participating in the rankings seriously. This would provide them a framework for academic management along global best practices. The new universities have to take of successfully overcoming the nation stage hurdles. A robust management focused on institution building is the key. The book released today containing the memoirs of 18 former vice chancellors would provide valuable lessons to our current academic leaders. Please do remember the words of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, which I quote: loyal and efficient work in a great cause, even though it may not be immediately recognized, ultimately bears fruit, unquote. In the end, I compliment the awardees once again. The visitors' awards, I hope, will motivate the central universities and the academic communities therein to work relentlessly towards excellence. I wish each one of you the very best in your future endeavors. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Jai Hind.
It's my honor and privilege to extend a vote of thanks to the Honorable President for taking this great initiative of starting the three annual awards from year 2015 for innovation, research, and overall best central university. Honorable Sir, these awards have already generated a very healthy competition amongst all the central universities. Being only the third year of the awards, the relatively newer universities could not so far participate in them. However, an effort has started in all the central universities with the objective of achieving more that can enable them to win these awards in the future. I also express my gratitude to the Honorable President for his thought-provoking and inspirational address. This will help and motivate all the leaders in the central universities and we in the Ministry of Human Resources Development to engage with our task of building the higher education in the country yet more seriously and deeply.
I also thank the Honorable Minister for Human Resources Development for his constant guidance and encouragement. Under your able guidance, sir, the department has been able to take many path-breaking initiatives to improve the quality of higher education in our country. I would also like to thank the Secretary to the President for her meticulous guidance and for making the whole process of selection of these awards a very objective and transparent one. I also thank the distinguished members of the jury for sparing their time and making their valuable contribution in selecting the most deserving for these awards. I extend my heartiest congratulations to all the award winners. At the end, I again thank the Honorable President of India for this great initiative of instilling the annual awards for innovation, research, and the best central university. Thank you.